What is up, everyone? Today we are going to talk about graphical representation of group data. My name is Mohammad Abdullah Sarkar, and please turn on your captions if you need help in following along. So why bother with graphical representation? Well, it has been rightly said that a picture speaks a thousand words. Graphical representation of data helps us display our data in a neat and memorable format. It allows us to compare different data sets at a glance and to find different correlation between different factors within each data set. For example, a graph linking the occurrence of lung cancer with the intensity of smoking tells you that there is a correlation between the two. On top of that, it shows the trends of any data set and enables you to predict the next data entry or the next move of the trend. This is something stock marketing analysts will definitely agree with. Let's look at a histogram. It is basically a bar graph of frequency distribution. We will talk about bar graphs and line diagrams separately when we talk about ungrouped data and its representation. You can see how it looks like. Moving on, let's try to make a histogram for ourselves. Here's a table we're going to be using for example. For all intents and purposes, we are going to use boundary limits. We have talked about boundary limits before in a video as well, which you can find on the card being displayed on the top right side of this video. Besides that, we are going to create two extra classes with zero frequencies. One of these classes will be made the lowest class and the other one will be made the highest class. Hence, in this table, we will be adding the classes 14.5 to 19.5 and 69.5 to 74.5. The lower limits of each class will be plotted on the x-axis, while a suitable scale will be chosen for the y-axis to depict the frequencies. Now, we just have to draw out the histogram. The histogram on the right depicts the frequency distribution on the left. You may pause the video and observe how boundary limits have been chosen along the x-axis. Not only that, the true extra classes have zero frequencies so as to not alter the data of frequency distribution. Now, what's a frequency polygon? It's basically the line diagram of a frequency distribution. You can get a frequency polygon from a histogram by simply joining the midpoints of the upper base of each bar in a histogram by straight lines. The graph I have made is not accurate, for I made it in a hurry. The difference between a frequency curve and a frequency polygon is that the latter is a closed shape. That means that the practice of taking two extra classes is not needed while making a frequency curve. Those two extra classes make sure that our polygon remains a closed figure. Creating a frequency polygon from a frequency distribution table is also easy. First of all, make two extra classes with zero frequencies, one before the lowest class and one after the highest class. Then plot the midpoints of each class along the x-axis and choose a suitable scale for the y-axis. Now, locate the points on the graph and join every subsequent pair of them with a straight line as depicted in the figure. You may have noticed that the polygon was not the smoothest one you have seen. That happens if the total number of frequencies is too small, which basically means the sample size is too low. Another reason for that is that there might have been a great variation between the frequencies of different classes. The best way to smoothen a polygon is to simply include more cases in your survey. However, if you cannot do that, then apply the formula given on the screen to acquire the smooth frequency of each class. You can see that if we apply that formula to our example table, we receive smooth frequencies for all our classes easily. So, what is the main difference between a polygon and a histogram? Well, definitionally, a histogram is a bar graph of the frequency distribution, while a polygon is a line graph of the distribution. The polygon does not show you the distribution of frequencies within each class as clearly as a histogram does. However, a polygon is more practical because polygons of two or more datasets can be plotted on the same axis to help in comparative analysis, while a histogram requires a separate axis for each dataset. Polygons are also better at conveying trends in the dataset, which help us predict the direction of future data. That was it for this one, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to click that subscribe button and like this video. If you have any queries, do let me know in the comment section. See ya.